What is going on, YouTube? This is Lawrence over at Mighty Comics and Collectibles, and I've been getting a lot of questions lately asking me what are some of the undervalued comics out there still left in the market. As you guys know, the market for the past year for comics has been absolutely insane. A ton of major keys have gone up tremendously in value, and of course even some smaller keys have doubled and tripled in price. So people have been asking me, what are some books out there I can still buy, I could still look for to add to the collection that I can get some monetary value out of? So what I did was I compiled a list according to price. So I have like a bunch of books in one price range, a bunch of books in another price range for people who can only spend a certain amount of money. So I broke it down. I have a lot of books to go through today to tell you what I think we should be looking for and I think are good deals right now. The one thing I have noticed is that the market is starting to dip a little bit. So a lot of the big keys are starting to come down in value, not a lot, but a little. So now's the time I think that we can pounce on some of these things, and I'm gonna go through them one by one here on the list. But before we get started, guys, like we always do, if you're not a current subscriber of the channel, you are missing out. Right now, I do a once a month video about a statue from Diamond Select Toys that you guys could win if you like, subscribe, and comment on that video. So make sure you're checking those out every month. Of course, I have a 2,000 subscriber giveaway contest that's also going on right now, so find that video and follow the directions in order to enter. But also, it really does help the channel out. So we're going to jump right in here. We're going to talk about a bunch of books that I think you could still buy right now depending on your price point. So I'm going to start with the most expensive books right now, the higher dollar amount books that I think that are still are good deals out there that you can get right now. The first one we're going to talk about is Showcase number 22, the first Silver Age appearance of the Green Lantern. Now, I don't talk about a lot of DC books a lot, but this is one of these books that to me is really still underpriced. You can still get a 2.0 CGC, CBS, whatever you want, a graded copy for $3,009, which to me, I still think is a steal considering it is a nice Silver Age first appearance book. It's a DC book, so all these Warner Brothers movies has been keeping this book down right now, so I would definitely pounce on this book right now. If you're a DC fan, if you're a Green Lantern fan, I know there's a Green Lantern show, I think coming to HBO or HBO Max, so if you want to take a chance on this book and hang on to it for a while, I think it's a good buy. The next one we're going to talk about is a copy of Daredevil number 1, and you can get a 2.0 copy for $3,000. So like I said, anybody who wants to spend, you know, the couple thousand dollar range, who want to invest some big money into a key issue, this is still an undervalued Silver Age key. To me, I own two copies of that book right now, and I still think it's undervalued. When I talk about this book, I talk about it, you know, being one of the Silver Age grails that is really underpriced. I mean, you look at AF-15, we look at some of the big boys, they're tens of thousands of dollars for low grades. So you're talking about a 2.0 for $3,000. I still think that's a good deal. I'd be picking it up. The next one we're going to talk about is a copy of Incredible Hulk number 181. Now, I have talked about this book a lot considering there's a ton of copies out there. People have been scooping this book up every chance that they get, and there's a lot of copies on eBay still for sale. But to me, you can still get a 4.0 copy of this book for $3,700, and that I think is a steal considering how popular Wolverine is. You know, I was worried a little bit that, you know, there's so many copies out there, but you know, people have brought up the point to me that this is the thing they're going to go to after the AF-15, Action Comics 1, and Detective 27. This is the next big grail after those big three. So to me, yes, there is a supply, but to me, $3,700 for a 4.0 copy, I still, I think, is undervalued, and I'd be picking one up right now if you guys can afford it. And the last book I'm going to talk about for this high price point range is Giant Size X-Men number 1, which of course is the second appearance of Wolverine, but also the first appearance of the new X-Men team. Again, a book that I acquired maybe about a year ago from my LCS. You can still get a 4.0 copy of this book for $2,699. That's right, just under $2,700. You can have a decent grade copy of this book. And to me, I still think this book is going to go screaming higher. It's gone up a lot over the past year with the announcement of Fox going over to Disney. But to me, again, this is a long-term book. I still think it's undervalued. I still think it's going to go higher in the near future. So it's some book I'd be definitely picking up. The next tier of books are going to be anything under $2,000 to around $1,500. Okay, guys? So anyone who doesn't have that $2,500, $3,000 to spend on a book, but you want to get something that's a little pricey, there are still good investments out there. So we're going to start with, of course, one of my favorites, Fantastic Four, number 48, The First Appearance of the Silver Surfer. Now, this book got screaming hot right when Fox was bought out by Disney. I mean, it was insane. But right now, you can get a 3.0 copy, which is a very good plus, for $1,800. And I still think you can get a better, even better deal on that, because this book has really started to come in a little bit. Yes, I think you should buy this book right now before the Silver Surfer shows up in an MCU movie. This is number one in that price range for me right now, what I'd be buying. It's a close second to something else we're getting into next, which of course is Amazing Spider-Man number 129, The First Appearance of Frank Castle and the Punisher. Not only is this one of my favorite books, one of my favorite covers that I've seen from the Bronze Age, to me, I still think this book is undervalued for what it is. Right now you can get a 5.0 copy of this book for $1,900. To me, that's still a steal. All right, I purchased my 8.0 129 a couple of years back. I bought it for $1,100, believe it or not. Now look where that book is. It's probably almost a $4,000 book. To me, when Frank Castle shows up in probably a Disney Plus show, it's not going to be an MCU movie, it's going to be too late to buy this book, unless you're going to hold on to it for 20 years. But to me, this is also one of the big Bronze Age books I'd still be buying. I still think it's undervalued. And right now, they're starting to come down in price a little bit. I think you could get even a 4.0 for like $1,400, $1,500. So keep that in mind. Okay, guys? The next one we're going to talk about is a Fantastic Four number 12. This is one of my favorite Jack Kirby covers that he's ever done. I talked about this book multiple times with the gray backgrounds, the Hulk and the Thing in there, the green and the orange. It's just really an awesome cover by Jack, and it's one of my favorite Silver Age books. But you could still have a 4.0 copy of this book for $1,500. To me, this is a classic. It's a no-brainer for me. It's something that I would hang on to for the rest of my life, because I just am in love with this book, and I still see this book going higher. And even the low grades, I still think are collectible, because there are a lot of beat-up copies of this book I see out there for some reason. I don't know why, but again, a book I'd always be buying for $1,500 if you'd want to spend that kind of money. The next one is probably my hottest comic that's coming out this year. It is a copy of Marvel Spotlight number 5, The First Appearance of Ghost Rider. This is a tough book right now to get in a high grade because of the black cover, but you can still get a 4.0 copy of this book for $1,600. And to me, I'd be pouncing all over this book right now. This is the next big key outside of Amazing Spider-Man number 129 and FF48 that I'd be buying right now in this price range. To me, I am searching for another copy as well. I want to add another a copy of this book before Ghost Rider shows up in a movie. It's just really tough to find right now. This is the one book that I think has not come down at all over the past beginning of 2022. So keep that in mind, guys. The next one I've actually owned before, and I wish I had it back. It's one of my favorite covers of all time. It is a copy of House of Secrets number 92, The First Appearance of Swamp Thing. And another DC book appears on my list. This has always been an undervalued key for what it is, a Bronze Age book as well. You can have a 5.0 right now for $1,500. To me, this is a book that will always go up in value no matter what DC does with this character, because of Bernie Wrightson, because of the cover, because of the character. Swamp Thing's been around forever. He's been in a ton of TV shows when I was growing up. I think they even did like a B movie. It wasn't a good one, but regardless, this book has stood the test of time, and it's a book I'd always be adding right now. So that's it for that tier. We're going to go into the next tier now, which is around $1,000, okay? Around $1,000, you can still get some awesome keys out there. And people out there are going to be like, that's a lot of money. That's a lot of money. Trust me, I'm going to get to the lower keys, but these are where these are right now. So I want to give you every tier if you want to buy something. The next one in this tier is a copy of Amazing Spider-Man number 50, The First Appearance of the Kingpin. I've been all over YouTube talking about this book for a better part of a year and a half. First Appearance of the Kingpin, the trifecta book, First Appearance, Spider-Man No More, the storyline, and of course the classic cover by John Romita. I'm always a buyer of this book, starting to drop now that the Kingpin has shown up in Hawkeye, so I'd be picking it up, and you can actually get a 4.0 for $1,000 right now, okay? The next one we're going to talk about is a modern book, and I don't collect too many modern books, guys. It is Ultimate Fallout number 4, The First Appearance of Miles Morales. Every time I talk about modern books, I talk about 9.6 or 9.8. That's it, right? I'm not going to throw a 9.8 up here because obviously that's a ton of money right now, over $3,000. So a 9.6 you can have for $1,200. To me, I still think that's a good deal for a really popular character right now. I know it's a modern book, it's a lot of money, but I'm still a buyer of this book because I still think it's going higher because of the popularity of Miles Morales. The next one we're going to talk about is a Silver Age key, Avengers number 4, the first Silver Age appearance of Captain America. I don't know why this book is so undervalued considering how important Captain America is. I know Captain America 1 is his true first appearance, but guess what? 99.9% of the people out there can't afford that book. So this is what we're going to go to next, and it's still really undervalued. You can get a 2.0 copy of this book for $1,099. To me, that's a steal. You get a Silver Age first appearance. Well worth it to me. I'm definitely all over this book. I actually own a 1.8 copy signed by Stan Lee. So to me, if you can get this book and it's complete and it's over like a 1.5, I'm definitely buying it. The next book in this price range, guys, is a copy of X-Men number 4, The First Appearance of Wanda. And of course, the first appearance of Quicksilver. Before the WandaVision series aired, guys, you could have had this book for super cheap. But like I said, once it aired, forget it, all bets were off, it went screaming higher. But over the past couple of months, it has really come back in. With Doctor Strange 2 right around the corner, I'd be picking up this book right now because you can have a 2.0 copy for around $1,050, which I think is super cheap and super affordable for this major key. The next one we're going to talk about is, of course, Incredible Hulk number 180, the first cameo appearance of Wolverine. For most people, I'd be buying 181. If you guys can afford that book, that's the book I'd be buying. But if you can't and you can only have about $1,000 to spend, you can have a 5.0 copy of 180 for $999. I think it's still worth it to pick up this key. Wolverine is a huge character in the MCU, in Marvel, and people love him. This book will continue to go higher in the near future. So if you don't own a copy and have that disposable $1,000, that's one of the books I'd be picking up. And the last book in this price range is a copy of X-Men number 94, the first appearance of the new X-Men team in their own run. Now, again, if I had a choice, I'd still be getting Giant Size X-Men number 1. I do think that's the better buy. But regardless of that, X-Men number 94 is a solid backup, and you can have a 7.0 for $1,000, which to me, I still think is a good buy because you know the X-Men are coming, right? Don't know if it'll be this team in the beginning. Eventually, I think we will see them, but might have the original team first or something that looks like the original team. Regardless, I do think this is a good pickup, and it's still undervalued. So we're going to talk about the next tier now. The next tier is anything under $1,000 to around $600-$700, around that price range, okay? We're going to start with Fantastic Four number 49, the first appearance of Galactus, but also the second appearance of the Silver Surfer. This is one of my favorite Silver Age keys, and a 3.0 right now will run you about $950. To me, it's a book I want to buy, a book I want to own for when Galactus does show up, and he will show up. Definitely a buy for me, guys. The next one is another DC key. It is Detective Comics number 359, the first appearance of Batgirl. This book you could have had for around $300, $320 at some point in this grade, but a 4.0 right now will cost you only $900. I know you hear me say only $900. It is a lot of money, but again, a book with tremendous potential. Again, you have to be leery about these DC keys because Warner's seems to screw everything up, and I'm not really a huge fan of that Batgirl pictures that we got. Regardless, I do think this book will continue to go up over the next couple of years and beyond. So definitely a book I would buy. The next one is a major key, and definitely if you do not own this book, I would 100% pick it up. It is a copy of Amazing Spider-Man number 300, the first appearance of Venom. Now, again, I call this a modern key because I know it was 1988, but to me it's a modern book. So I'm only picking up this book in a 9.2 or higher. That's where I think this book, you're going to get the most bang for your buck. You can have a 9.2 right now for $950. To me, I think you should do it. Pounce on this book before it goes any higher. Again, like we talked about with Miles Morales, he's a tremendously popular character. So is Venom. If not, I think Venom is more popular because he's been around a lot longer. 100% pick this book up if you guys can. Still undervalued. Next one after that is something along the lines of Ultimate Fallout 4. It is Edge of Spider-Verse number 2, the first appearance of Spider-Gwen. That's right, another modern key, and I don't talk about modern keys enough, but I do own this book as well, and you can get a 9.6 graded copy of this book for $800. That's right, only $800, under $1,000. Definitely a book I'd be specking on too, because you know eventually Sony's going to put out a Spider-Gwen movie. She's going to show up in a live action film, and you want to be ready and you want to own this book for when it happens. The next one is a book that was actually just on the Hot 10 list, guys. If you haven't checked out the latest Hot 10 breakdown, go ahead. I will drop a link at the end of this video. It is a copy of Doctor Strange number 169, the first Doctor Strange in his own title. So it goes from Strange Tales over to Doctor Strange, right? Again, a really awesome cover. One of my favorite covers from this era as well. The better of the Doctor Strange covers, I will add. You can have this book right now in a 7.0 for $720. So to me, I want a high grade copy of this book because it is such a beautiful cover. I don't really want to invest in a low grade. A 7.0 is still affordable to me at $720. Definitely add it to the collection because I do think it's going to go up. Next one on this price range is X-Men number 12, The First Appearance of the Juggernaut. Again, another book I've been talking about for the better part of a year. Undervalued. Juggernaut is a huge character, definitely a fan favorite, and right now you can get a 2.5 copy for $610. This book has really come back down. Again, I think a 2.5 at some point was closer to $1,000. Now back down to $610. To me, I'm pulling the trigger if I see this book around that price range. Very popular character, guys. Silver Age X-Men key. Anytime I can get a nice Silver Age first appearance, a big first appearance for under $1,000, I'm likely to pull the trigger if it's around FMV, okay? The next one is another X-Men book, X-Men number 101, The First Appearance of the Phoenix. I've owned this book in the past at around a 4.0 range. I want a higher grade if I'm going to buy it right now. And I want to look at a 7.0. 7.0 will run you about $695. I know the Phoenix has appeared in, you know, Fox films before, not in the MCU. And I do think it'll be quite a while before we see this character. So you do have time if you need to wait in order to pick it up. But a book, again, I want to own going forward in the MCU. The next one is an interesting one because I just picked up a copy a couple of months back. It is a copy of Daredevil number 7, The First Appearance of Daredevil's Red Costume. That's right, no more banana suit, right? This book has really gotten expensive along the lines of all the other Daredevil keys are starting to creep up there. But again, it's still undervalued. Right now, you can get a 4.0 copy of this book for around $600, and I still think it's worth it. While we may see the banana suit in the MCU at some point, it'll probably just be like a quick scene or a throwback. We're not going to get, like, he's not going to roam around in that yellow costume. He's going to show up in his classic red suit eventually, and this book is going to take off. Again, another highly valued key I'd be buying right now. And the last one in this price point, around $750 to $900 and change, is a copy of Tales of Suspense, number 52, The First Appearance of the Black Widow. And I cannot tell you why this book really hasn't gone up in value. You know, it's been, ever since I got back to the hobby, I was doing this for about 4 years when I started getting back into it. And you could have had that book for around $300-$400 in low grade. Now it's gone up a little bit. A 3.0 will run you $775. But to me, to get, again, a nice Silver Age first appearance for under $1,000, to me it is worth it for the long term. If you want to own this book, I know she's no longer in the MCU, but regardless, she's a major character in the Avengers. You want to own this book. Highly undervalued, and I definitely would pick it up for the long term. All right, so we're going to get into the next round now. The next round goes from around $500, okay? Next set of books around $500, okay? And there are a lot of them. So we're going to start with Tales of Suspense, number 57, The First Appearance of Hawkeye. Again, another book that may come down now that the Hawkeye series is over. We think he's done with the Avengers. Regardless, you can have this book right now for a 3.0 for around $550. Again, a nice Silver Age key for well under $1,000. I'm adding it every time I see it. The next one is a book I think certain people are specking on, but certain people have forgotten about. It is a copy of Fantastic Four Annual, number 6, The First Appearance of Annihilus. Now, while this is not my favorite cover, this book can still be had for relatively cheap. A 5.0 will run you about $499, which to me I think is a steal, especially because it's an annual and it's a thicker book. A 5.0 is still really cheap. You compare that book to other thick books like Amazing Spider-Man Annual number 1 or, you know, Silver Surfer number 4, they're all like torn to shreds and they're all like $1,500. This one is not. You can still get it for around $500. Definitely a buy in my opinion. The next book is a book I've been talking about forever and I can't believe how cheap it is. It is a copy of Iron Fist number 14, The First Appearance of Sabretooth. If you guys haven't listened to me yet and have picked up a copy of this book, you can still get a 7.5, very fine copy, high grade copy of this book for $500. Sabretooth is eventually going to show up when Wolverine shows up. It's a given, right? They're arch nemesis. They go at each other all the time. If you don't own this book, guys, for $500 and you want to have that price range that you want to spend something for $500, this is a good key to have. It still hasn't shot up. Eventually, it's going to. So add it if you haven't. I recommend it. The next one is a book I think everybody's been specking on. It's a copy of Amazing Spider-Man number 101, The First Appearance of Morbius. Now, I currently own two copies of this book. Excuse me. And for $500, you can own a 4.0 copy of this book. With Morbius coming out on April 1st, hopefully it doesn't get pushed back again. You want to own this book before this movie comes out. I don't think it's going to shoot to the moon. It's one of those books that I think will constantly go up, go up, go up, go up. It will go up a lot more when he meets Spider-Man, 100%. That's what everybody wants to see. Great, we're going to see a Morbius movie, but we want him face off against Spider-Man, and that's when this book will take off. The next one on this price tier is a copy of Amazing Spider-Man number 194, The First Appearance of Felicia Hardy, the Black Cat. Again, I've spoken about this character ad nauseum. I want to see her. I'm sick of MJ. I'm sick of Gwen Stacy. We've seen them done twice already in movies. We haven't seen Black Cat, and I love the storylines with her and Spider-Man in the comics. To me, it's one of my faves. I'd be all over this book right now in high grade, right? High grade is where I want to buy it every time. Right now, you can get an 8.0 copy of this book, and I actually own an 8.0 for $550. To me, it's still cheap. A Bronze Age key, a Bronze Age first appearance, beautiful black cover, and high grade. How could you not? Definitely pick this one up, guys, because this is one of my favorites for 2022. The next book in this price range is a copy of Amazing Spider-Man number 238, The First Appearance of the Hobgoblin. Now, we all thought that Ned was going to turn into the Hobgoblin in Spider-Man No Way Home. He was going to be that sixth villain. It didn't happen, right? So this book, I expect to kind of come back to life a little bit, come back down in price. Hopefully that's the case over the next couple of months. Regardless, right now you can get an 8.0 very fine copy of this book for around $500. It's a book I'd always buy. I picked mine up only like 6 or 7 months ago for $400 and change. I have an 8.0 signed by John Romita Jr. To me, yes, we always got to buy this book. Eventually, I think, you know, the MCU won't have a Green Goblin. I don't think they're going to go in that route. So we may get a Hobgoblin down the line. I hope it is still Ned. And now that Peter doesn't know who Ned is, or that Ned doesn't know who Peter Parker is anymore, maybe that will happen. That's what I'm hoping anyway. Regardless, make sure if you're going to buy this book that it has that tattoos and it is complete. That's the most important thing. But again, another undervalued key in my opinion. Next on this part is a copy of Batman number 227. Classic cover by Neil Adams, one of my favorite DC covers of all time. This beautiful black book is, I believe, a throwback to Detective Comics, I think 31. I could be wrong on that number. Regardless, again, a 5.0 copy of this book can only be had for around $500 as well. I actually have my copy signed by Neil Adams, CGC yellow label. It looks beautiful with that yellow label, guys. So if you're going to pick up a copy and want one that's signed by Neil, it does look great. Next one is another book also signed by Neil Adams. It is a copy of Batman number 251, classic cover, classic Joker cover. This is the book that kind of ushered in, I think, the Bronze Age of comics, if I'm not mistaken. Regardless, you can have a 5.0 copy of this book for around $495. To me, definitely worth it. Definitely a book that I would love to have in the collection, keep in the collection, because it is a classic cover. The next one is a book that I wasn't sure I was going to add onto this list, but I figured why not, because you never know in Marvel if they're going to bring this character around. It is a copy of Marvel Premiere number 15, The First Appearance of Iron Fist. Now, this book went up when kind of like the Netflix characters started coming over through Marvel and we heard about it. Then all of a sudden it started to tank again, but you could still get a high grade copy of this book, an 8.0 for $525. To me, it's still worth it at a high grade to own this book for around $500. I'm definitely a buyer. I want to hold it just in case Marvel does decide to release this character, and you never know, guys, they might. The next one is a book that was on the Hot 10 list as well. It is a copy of Astonishing Tales number 25, The First Appearance of Deathlok. To me, right now, this is a Bronze Age key not many people are talking about. I know it was on the Hot 10, but regardless, an 8.0 very fine copy of this book can be had for $450. We're talking about a character that not a lot of people, you know, are involved in or are emotionally involved in. It's a great yellow cover comic. To me, in the Bronze Age, a lot of those yellow covers are worth it just for the cover. Again, for $450, it's a book I'm willing to add, stash away, and keep it away for a while to see if Marvel does anything with the character. The next one is a Silver Age key in this price point. It is a copy of Daredevil number 2, the second appearance of Daredevil, but also the second appearance of Electro. To me, a double second appearance makes this book a buy if you can get it for a good price. I'm not a huge second appearance buyer. If I do, I want it for cheap. But this is a book that I really want because I love this cover. And a 3.0 will run you about 400 bucks right now. To me, if you could find this book, I would add it, especially if you can't have the first Electro or the first Daredevil. This is a nice alternative if you can get it for a good price. That's the key word, right? For a good price. 400 bucks, I think, is a decent price. The next one is a book that was also on the Hot 10. It is a copy of Daredevil number 131, The First Appearance of Bullseye. Whenever I speak about this book, I talk about the yellow cover as well. I talk about the first appearance of a major villain for Daredevil. Yes, I'm a buyer of this book 100%, and right now an 8.0 will run you only 450 bucks. Again, probably one of my top Bronze Age picks that I would pick up right now, along with Marvel Spotlight 5, if you can get that book and you have that kind of dough to kind of shell out. This one, Daredevil 131, Amazing Spider-Man 129, those Bronze Age keys right now, they're really, really getting hot. This one, probably not going to get a pullback in price because of how hot it's been, but regardless, I still think an 8.0 copy, and that's where I want to go on this book, 8.0 or higher for 450 is not that bad. The next one is a book I cannot believe. When I saw the price on this at this grade, I'm shocked it's this low. It is a copy of Iron Man number one, the first Iron Man in his own solo series. A 4.5, believe it or not, will only run you 550 bucks, which I can't believe. I have a 4.5 copy, believe it or not. Mine is signed by Gene Colan. And I think I paid like 200 and something bucks for it way back when. But regardless, 550 for a classic Iron Man 1. The cover on this book is absolutely astonishing. To me, yes, I'm always adding it. I just don't know why it hasn't gone up so much. Like, Tales of Suspense 39 has gone through the roof. Why hasn't this book appreciated? I can't answer that question, but I definitely want to own it. And I definitely think it's undervalued. So that's it for around the $500 price point. There are a lot of books in that area that I still think are great buys at these prices, guys. So take that for what it's worth. The last, you know, batch of books are anywhere from under 400 bucks or at $400. So take that for what it's worth. There's not a lot of books right now that I was going through this list thinking I really want to own this book before it's too late. So keep that in mind. A lot of the books that I go with are Silver Age or Bronze Age keys. There are a little copper thrown in there as well. Modern, only one or two, right? That's it. So the last price range we're going to talk about, 400 or under. First one I'm going to talk about is X-Men number 129, The First Appearance of Kitty Pryde. I'll start by saying this is my giveaway book, one of my giveaway books for the 2,000 subscriber contest entry. Errol was kind enough to donate two books, and this was one of them. And a 9.0 will run you about now, 370 bucks, totally worth it for the first appearance of Kitty Pryde. You never know going forward, now that Disney owns the Fox rights to X-Men, we're going to see them eventually. I'm assuming we're going to see this character, and this book is going to skyrocket even higher. But it has come down. Right, guys? This book was super hot at one point. It has cooled off a little bit, so now I'd be picking it up. The next one is a book, again, that was on the Hot 10 list last week. It is a copy of Amazing Spider-Man number 252, The First Appearance of the Black Suit in the main title. I've been preaching on this book for a couple of years now. The symbiote is such an important aspect of Spider-Man and Peter Parker. It's a great storyline that I hope we get to see in the MCU at some point. We do know that the symbiote has stayed over in the Spider-Man No Way Home. Regardless, a 9.4 will only cost you 375 bucks. To me, that's still not bad for a high-grade copy of this book. I prefer 9.2 or higher on this book. I gave you a 9.4 price because I thought it was still undervalued at that grade. The next one we're going to talk about is a copy of Daredevil number 168, The First Appearance of Elektra. Again, another book that when Daredevil comes, Bullseye's going to come, Elektra's going to follow. We saw her in the Netflix series, so she might not show up right in the beginning. It might take her a while to show up because we all know what happened in the Netflix series if you watched it. Great show. Regardless, you can have an 8.0 copy of that book for 330 bucks. And again, I want to stick to an 8.0 or higher on these books, okay, guys? Both the 131 and the 168, we want 8.0s or higher. Next one is a book I really spec'd on about like a year and a half ago. It went up a little bit, but hasn't really gone through the roof yet. It is a copy of Marvel Spotlight number 32, The First Appearance of Jessica Drew as Spider-Woman. There is some rumors out there that the Black Cat is getting her own movie, and there is a rumor that Marvel Spotlight 32, the first appearance of the new Spider-Woman, is going to be in that movie. That's the rumor. So to me, I'm glad I own three copies of this book, and a 9.0 will only cost you right now around 400 bucks. I picked the highest grade because I think you should stick to the higher grades, and this 9.0 or higher for $400. It's definitely a book I'd spec on for the future, even though it's Sony, regardless of Marvel, right? It's a big book. At some point, she's going to show up. And the last book on this entire list, I know it's been a long one. I'm glad you guys stuck to the end of the video. It's a copy of Ms. Marvel 18, the first full appearance of Mystique. I own this book in my collection. It's a beautiful cover. Not a lot of Ms. Marvel books are really worth a ton of money. This one is. And you can have an 8.0 first appearance of Mystique for only $200. To me, that is well worth it. We've seen Mystique before in a bunch of other movies. Eventually, she will show up again when they do the X-Men movies. It just may take a while. So it's a book, again, I want to own in high grade. And for 8.0, very fine copy for only $200, 100% I'm a buyer. Add it to the collection. Wait for 5 to 10 years down the road. She will show up again, and this book will probably be worth double or triple that. So that's it for the video, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. It was a long one. There are a lot of books out there that, to me, are still undervalued, books I'd still rather buy. It all depends on what's your price range, right? Your price range is tens of thousands of dollars. It's not that bad. You're going to find something easy. If your price range is from like $2,500, $3,000, there's still a bunch of books out there that I think are undervalued. And a lot of them I put on this list. $1,500, $2,000, $1,000, $500. I gave you all options right here of books that I think are still undervalued and books that I want to add to the collection. So with that said, guys, if you're not a current subscriber of the channel, click that subscribe button. I want you to like this video. Comment down below. Let me know if I left something off the list. We may do a part two if I find more books, so keep that in mind. And with that said, this is Lawrence over at Mighty Comics and Collectibles saying thank you for watching, and I'll talk to you guys soon.